Today, a jury found Graham Spanier guilty. Graham Spanier, Tim Curley, and Gary Schultz were each in positions of authority and had information of young boys being sexually abused by Jerry Sandusky. Instead of reporting it to authorities, they consciously turned their backs and the abuse continued. These leaders endangered the welfare of children by both their actions and their inactions. There are zero excuses when it comes to failing to report the abuse of children to the appropriate authorities, whether to a child abuse hotline, to law enforcement, or to child welfare officials. No one is above the law, especially when it comes to the welfare of children. And my office will hold anyone accountable who abuses or fails to protect children. I want to thank and commend our outstanding prosecutors, Laura Ditka, Patrick Schulte, Greg Simatic, for their work in the courtroom over these last several days, as well as all of their efforts leading up to the verdict just moments ago. Let me also recognize agents Tony Cesano and Jess Eager for their outstanding work, as well as Jess Horner, who kept everything together. I also want to thank the many attorneys and agents in the Office of Attorney General who spent years working on multiple investigations involving abuse in this case. I am grateful to them for their exemplary service to the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. I also appreciate the work of State Police Sergeant Jeff Dombrowski and his colleagues who worked on this case for many years. At this time, it's my pleasure to recognize the Office of Attorney General's lead prosecutor in this successful case, Laura Ditka. Laura?
Thank you, General.
Could you explain the charges?
He was found guilty of endangering the welfare of children in that he had a duty of care and protection for the children that came to Penn State campus, and he failed in that duty. He was acquitted of failing to make the report and conspiracy.
And is the conviction for a misdemeanor because of the grading on the course of conduct?
Yes.
And what is the sentencing range for that?
5 years and $10,000 is a maximum sentence.
And was there any issue about bail brought up?
The Commonwealth did not seek to revoke bail.
What do you consider to be the most important aspect of the trial? Why do you think the jury decided to put it this way? What is it about the evidence that would support the verdict?
I think the most important aspect of the trial was that the focus stayed on the children. This has always been a trial about children, their well-being, and their welfare. And I think the office successfully kept the focus on children, and the jury kept their focus successfully on children.
The former co-defendant's testimony was probably not what was expected. Were you worried at any point that the case might have been jeopardized by their testimony?
We've all been doing this for a long time, so we know what to expect when you have co-conspirators testifying. And so I don't think it was as unexpected as perhaps all of you thought it was. I think that they gave us important pieces of evidence. They gave important facts for this jury to reach their conclusion. And I think it was important that they stood up and accepted responsibility on their own for their own wrongdoing in this matter. I think he had a selective memory. However, he still gave us important information, and he still took responsibility for his wrongdoing in this action.
The county was convicted of. Is it accurate to say that it was for children in general at Penn State, or was it for the victim too, the child Michael Query saw? What was he convicted of?
He was convicted for all the children that came into Penn State after what Mike McQuarrie saw that night.
Do you expect Greg Spanier to serve jail time?
We aren't there yet. That would be in the province of the court.
The hope that he serves jail time.
We aren't there yet.
Do
Do you think the two not guilty counts lessen the impact of the guilty count?
No, I think anytime you get a verdict that shows that people are focused on the well-being of children, I think that's a major victory.
Are you in any way disappointed that after all of this we're down to a misdemeanor charge?
No. There's been a conviction of Jerry Sandusky, a conviction of Graham Spanier, a conviction of Tim Curley, and a conviction of Gary Schultz. I'd be foolish to be disappointed.
Okay. Any other question? How harmed was this case by the fact that you lost the obstruction of justice and perjury counts last year? I mean, it seemed like that was sort of like the main pillar of the case. This was sort of add-on originally. And then with that Supreme Court decision, Bruce Castro's decision, all of a sudden this became center stage. How difficult would that make this prosecution for you?
We're 3-for-3, so obviously not too difficult.
And why is that 3-for-3?
Spanier convicted, Curley convicted, Schultz convicted. 3 convictions. I think the high point was the focus on the victim that had the courage to come forward and testify, and Mike McQuarrie, who continues to tell his truth. And I don't think there were really any low points.
Thank you.